Hello, welcome back to Literature Literate channel, and today we're going to learn a beautiful poem, Something on a Summer's Day by Emily Dickinson. Emily Elizabeth Dickinson was an American poet. Dickinson was born in Amherst in 1830. She was a prolific poet. Only 10 of her nearly 1800 poems were published during her lifetime. Her poems contain short lines, often use slant rhymes. Slant rhyme means formed by words with similar but not identical sounds. Many of her poems deal with themes of death and immortality. This poem, A Something in a Summer's Day, is something like an ode to summer, its greatness and its wonder. This poem consists of 7 stanzas with 3 lines each except the last one. The first 2 lines of each stanza are written in iambic pentameter, while the third line is written in iambic tetrameter. The stanzas are written in AAB rhyme scheme. Before seeing the line by line explanation of this poem, if you haven't yet subscribed to this channel, you can do it now. Like, share and subscribe to this channel. Let me read the poem lines. A something in a summer's day, as slow her flame flags burn away, which solemnizes me. A something in a summer's noon, a depth, an azure, a perfume, transcending ecstasy. And still within a summer's night, a something so transporting bright, I clap my hands to see. Then veil my too inspecting face, lest such a subtle shimmering grace flutter too fair for me. The wizard fingers never rest, the purple brook within the breast still chafes its narrow bed. Still rears the east her amber flag, guides still the sun along the crack his caravan of red. So looking on, the night, the morn conclude the wonder game, and I meet coming through the dews another summer's day. Let's go to the first stanza. A something in a summer's day, as slow her flambacks burn away, which solemnizes me. As I told you already, this poem is about a summer's day. This poem, Emily Dickinson has described a summer's day from dawn to night. A something in a summer's day, as slow her flambacks. Flambacks means a large candlestick with several branches. This line, her, refers to the summer's day, and her flambacks refers to the stars. At dawn, I mean before sunrise, we can see many stars in the sky burn away. That means slowly reduces its brightness, which solemnizes me. Solemnizes means celebrate a ceremony, that of a marriage. So the beginning of a summer's day gives a feeling like ceremony to the poet. Let's go to the second stanza. A something in a summer's noon, a depth, an azure, a perfume, transcending ecstasy. In this stanza, Emily Dickinson has described the morning. The morning is a depth, an azure. Azure means bright blue color, and the sky is in the bright blue in color, like a cloudless sky, and a perfume. The fresh morning is having a special smell and transcending ecstasy. Ecstasy means an overwhelming feeling of great happiness or joyful excitement. Third stanza. And still within a summer's night, a something so transporting bright, I clap my hands to see. And the brightness of the summer's day is carrying throughout the day, I mean up to the night time. So this makes the poet to clap her hands and enjoy. Fourth stanza. Then veil my too inspecting face, lest such a subtle shimmering grace flutter too fair for me. In this stanza, she says about the fireflies. Veil means cover, and shimmering means shining with a soft, slightly wavering light. The fireflies are so shimmering and flutter too fair for the poet. Stanza. The wizard fingers never rest, the purple brook within the breast still chafes its narrow bed. Wizard means a man who has magical powers, and brook means a small stream, and chafes means Rub. The majestic color purple has been associated with the magic and mystery. Here the wizard fingers refers to the small river which is running through its narrow path. Let's go to the next answer. Still rears the east her amber flag, guides still the sun along the crack, his caravan of red. The east telling the sun to start rising like a flag, signaling the start of race. In this stanza, Dickinson references Greek mythology, specifically the myths of the Titan Helios and the great god Apollo, who were responsible for carrying the sun across the sky in a chariot. The caravan represents the red chariot of Apollo or Helios that carries the sun across the sky. The final stanza. So looking on the night, the morn conclude the wonder gay, and I meet coming through the dews another summer's day. She is happy when the day ends because she knows that the next day coming through the morning dew is another great summer day to enjoy. So according to Emily Dickinson, something like joyful happiness is there in the summer's day. Hope you enjoyed this beautiful ode. We will meet in the next video. Until then, bye.